Short beaten nails can be transformed into beautiful and elegant with PolyGel. Coming up. Hello, I'm Anastasia, and today we're going to transform short nails with PolyGel. Apply dehydrator and non-acid primer, and then let's start the application. First, I apply the product on the free edge, and I am going to do a short oval shape without using forms or tips. I am basically going to do this on air. I previously did something similar with acrylic, and I think it's a bit easier because acrylic cures fast, unlike PolyGel, which will cure only in the lamp, but it's still possible. I'm using IBD control gel. The color is called Natural, and this is one of the hardest PolyGels I ever tried, so I have no doubt that it will stay for a long time. And since we are touching the client's skin, make sure it doesn't have any wounds, it is not irritated or have any cuts, otherwise we may cause allergic reactions. This client has pretty wide nails, and since we are doing them short, I think oval shape will be ideal solution here. Now cure in LED for 1 minute, and I created the length and shape. Now it's time to create the structure. I apply the product right from the tube. I do not use spatula all the time. And now we're going to build the apex and all the rest. I probably took a little bit more product than I need, but it's not a problem because we can always get rid of the excess product before curing. Now make sure that the cuticle area is super thin, and for this kind of nails, short and beaten, I recommend you to always do a larger margin between the skin and the product. Otherwise, it may cause lifting and the product will be lifted really soon. Filing nails is not my favorite thing to do, and especially on this kind of nails where the skin is super sensitive, where the grooves are really deep. So I recommend you to do your best with the application so you will not need to file a lot. So I removed the excess product and now going to stretch the rest. Use control solution, which is the special PolyGel liquid, to smooth out the surface, but do not use too much. Now looks like we're done with this part, and let's cure it for another minute in LED. Let's switch to the next one. Usually I apply dehydrator and non-acid primer on all 10 nails, but here, since the nails are not the easiest to work with, I do it one by one, I just feel better about it. Those nails are not oily, neither is the skin, but if it was, I would recommend you also to use a base coat. Actually, I use it with most product, but sometimes if I'm confident about it, I just skip this part. We are doing the first step now, and you can make it thinner, you can make it thicker, it doesn't really matter. But the most important part is that it should be even, and I recommend you to check it from different points of view and make sure that the oval shape is symmetrical. This is crucial when doing oval or almond shapes. When you're happy about the shape, check it once again and cure in LED. This time for 30 seconds, as I'm going to pinch the nail as well. Separate it from the skin carefully and slightly pinch it, cure for remaining 30 seconds. Let's proceed. I applied the remaining product right from the tube. I did not take too much this time, since the first step I added more product than usual, so we have to add less. The nail is pretty short, so we do not need a huge apex here and too much product. When doing this kind of nails, remember, if you will apply too much product, it will make them look bulky, and that's not what we want, and also applying too much product more than needed may also lead to lifting of the product and the nails may likely to break. The opposite is also not good when the nails are paper thin, so it is important to keep the balance, not too thick and not too thin. I think for these nails, the ideal thickness is somewhere near credit card thickness. We all know the thickness of the credit cards, right? Well, even though they're a little bit different. Now I'm checking the cuticle area last, and looks like this is it, and then we can fully cure it for 1 minute. After curing, it is filing time, but first take off the sticky layer with the lint-free tissue. Usually I use regular file to shape the nails. Now when shaping oval shape, I recommend you to always look at all 10 nails, not at just one. And also make sure they are in the same style, because sometimes they can be more pointed or more wide. To file along the sidewalls and across the cuticle, I prefer this carbide bead. We can also file underneath a little bit if During application, you pressed on the product too much, so it may look a little thick, but be careful, do not overfile. Some of the last touches, then clean the dust and we can seal with the top coat, but we decided to apply a layer of new gel polish first because I experimented with some other colors on different nails, so we want to make them look all the same. When applying gel polish or top coat, especially if you're using the Soakoff top coat, you can apply it closer to the skin than you did with the poly gel. Cure and we're done here. This is how it looked when a client just came to me, and this is how it looked at the end. I hope you guys enjoyed this transformation. Let me know if you use poly gel for short beaten nails and which brand is your favorite. Thank you so much for watching. If you're first time here on my channel, consider subscribing as I post nail art tutorials and transformations just like this one every week. And I will see you in my next one. Goodbye!